The singularity, well, I mean, that's just something that we just don't understand.
It's a singular point, and that means the curvature of the space-time at this point has gone infinite, and all the mass has collapsed to one point. So it's a point, literally a point, with this mass in there, so it's got infinite density. You know, density is mass per unit volume. Well, if it's got no volume, it's an infinite density. These black holes that are defined in the sense of using general relativity. And this is this wonderful theory of Einstein, which explains how matter and curvature of space-time are intricately linked together.
So you really need a quantum theory of gravity to try to describe that. So, and I'm sure that a quantum theory of gravity will resolve the question of what the singularity is at the center of a black hole. It's just that we don't know what that is yet.
So that solution, as it stands, is there classically, but when you include the world of quantum mechanics, where things can get smeared out, what isn't clear is whether that singularity will remain, or maybe it will get smeared out. Will this event horizon still be there? So will that, what we think of as the black hole, still be there? It probably will.
What's that area like between the event horizon and the singularity? Is it like is that a tumultuous place, or do you not know you're in it? Like almost like the eye of a hurricane?
If you're heading into the black hole, and if this is a big enough black hole, you actually don't even know you've crossed this event horizon. In fact, the density of the black hole around the event horizon for a really massive black hole is of water. And so you just sort of pass through. But what begins to happen is you begin to experience the gravitational attraction. It begins, as you get closer and closer to the singularity, it gets bigger and bigger. And so you will begin to stretch. And you will begin to feel the effects of the pull of the black hole, and but on the other hand, for a solar mass black hole, you know, one of order the mass of the sun, then the pull of gravity on the event horizon is much stronger, and you will have already been spaghettified by the time you cross the event horizon. You won't see the event horizon. There's no signpost saying, you know, event horizon, no return. But you will pass through this. You will have already be gone in terms of living by then. But a supermassive black hole, you actually won't even realize. It's the pull is far less, the density of the matter is far less significant there than it would be in a smaller black hole.
Great, it's a good question. Okay, so if the black hole's big, if it's a big black hole, like maybe the one at the center of the Milky Way, then, you know, when it crosses the event horizon, well, forget firewalls for a second, but when it crosses the event horizon, you'd generally expect nothing much to happen, because actually the gravitational field's pretty weak out there. As you start to go deeper and deeper inside this black hole, you might think that, does it retain its status as a particle? I would say probably not, because you know, you're entering that regime where even your theory of gravity is breaking down. Well, let's think how an electron became an electron. Okay, so where does the electron get its mass from? It gets its mass from the Higgs particle, from the Higgs field, actually, more appropriately. And for it to get its mass from the Higgs field, something has to happen called spontaneous symmetry breaking. A symmetry has to be broken. Now, if you restore that symmetry, and that symmetry does get restored at high energies, then the electron loses its mass, and you know, you can't really talk about it. Eventually, the electron just becomes part of some greater thing, and that's what would happen. As you approach the black hole singularity, things would just, symmetries would be restored. You would no longer be able to describe matter in terms of what we think of the low energy matter dynamics. You would have to replace that by some high energy version of it, and eventually you'd have to replace things ultimately by the full quantum theory of gravity and everything, i.e. maybe string theory. So you're really talking about strings. So you would never even talk about you can't talk about an electron very, very close to singularity. You don't even have a singularity really. You've probably got some sort of stringy type structure, of which that electron has now become part and is itself some stringy excitation.
We do not know how to use gravity and quantum mechanics in regimes where gravity is incredibly strong and quantum mechanics is playing a big role. We can use our quantum theory is really well understood in regimes where gravity is not that strong. Gravity is really well understood in regimes where you don't need to worry about quantum mechanics, but we know both have to exist. We know we have to be able to understand the world of the macroscopic and the microscopic. And there are regimes where these two co- clash. And a black hole is a regime where you have the world of the microscopic quantum theory and the world of high-strength gravitational fields coming together. And a manifestation of this problem is this information issue, because it's defined simply in terms of its mass, its angular momentum, and its charge. It's got what's known as no hair. There's nothing coming out to tell you what's gone in there. The world of quantum mechanics, on the other hand, should also be able to describe this process. In the world of quantum mechanics, there is what's known as a wave function. It's integral to the world of quantum theory that we can keep track of this wave function. We solve it via the Schrödinger equation. Knowing about this wave function tells us about the probabilities of everything. We always expect probabilities to add to one. If they don't, then something's wrong with our system. When you lose information, it means that this wave function no longer is deterministic, in the sense that you lose that ability to have probabilities adding up to one. Something's gone wrong with your world of quantum mechanics, but we believe our world of quantum mechanics. So we have to be able to reconcile this classical picture of the black hole, where the information gets lost, to this quantum mechanical picture where we know the information shouldn't get lost. We need to be able to retrieve it. And in order to do it, you're having to match these two together.
The very existence of black holes and the singularity that you looks like you have at the center of them tells you that Einstein's theory is not a complete theory. It's at best an effective theory that it needs to be replaced by something else when you start talking about, you know, high energies, strong gravitational fields, and so on and so forth. You need something else, which is most likely string theory, I guess.
It's believed that the centers of galaxies have got these supermassive black holes, right? Up to billions of solar masses, which actually raises an interesting question. How did they form, right? How did these have time to... I think there might be some cosmic strings involved, but no one likes that idea. I'm just hoping they'll keep finding these supermassive black holes earlier and earlier and earlier and earlier, till eventually there's just not been enough time for black holes to coalesce, and you need another seed. Something like a massive cosmic string. But anyway, that's just my own pet hope.
Is it possible that as you start reconciling quantum mechanics and general relativity and understanding black holes better, that singularities could come under threat and people might think, oh, it's okay, there is actually a little bit of volume there?
Yes, absolutely. And I think the majority, I don't know about the majority, but a lot of people that think about what will be the effect of quantum mechanics is that singularity, which again is demonstrates a breakdown of your field equations, the breakdown of your mathematics, that singularity will get smoothed out.
An example of a star or an object whose gravity was so great that light couldn't escape from it.
So basically, what's being hinted at here for the first time is a black hole.
Of the existence of bodies under either of these circumstances, we could have no information from sight.